hello to all my BPTV fans, YouTube fans, and new fans. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine. I'm doing a holiday edition of the Talking Machine show, and what a great guest that I have for this show. I'll let him introduce himself right now.
Ho, 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 this is Santa. And I just flew down from the North Pole because I love this guy and I love Bethel Park. And I want to tell you all about some of my experiences as Santa Claus.
Santa, you're the best. I'm so glad I met you in the past week. We've become friends. Earlier today, we swapped a half a dozen stories. So we'll see what we can put on this TV show.
Good, good.
All right. Can you tell me some of your favorite experiences as Santa?
Certainly. Let me tell you some funny ones and then some serious ones. Santa not only goes to little children but does light up night, but he also does adult parties.
Whoa.
Yes, I do adult parties too, and I've got a couple stories about that.
Sure.
But you know, it's funny. I just did Bethel Park's light up night.
How did that go?
Fantastic. Fantastic. The mayor and I, we've been doing this together. I get over to the recreation center.
Yeah.
And I come up. The mayor introduces me.
Yeah, Jack's a favorite of mine.
Oh, Jack is excellent, really excellent. And I go up on stage, and this year, magically, I lit the Christmas tree. We did a beautiful countdown with the children from 10 all the way down to 1, and boom, we lit the tree. And then something different. Besides singing, and there's three of my favorite songs that we sing, I ask the children, as I'm ringing my bells, what song does that remind you of? And all the kids shout, Jingle Bells! And we start singing Jingle Bells. And then I ask them, do you remember what my red-nosed reindeer's name is? Rudolph! And I says, what song does that remind you of? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. And we sing that. And the last one is Santa Claus is Coming to Town.
Of course.
Yeah.
Makes sense. So those are your top three.
Top three. And something that a lot of people have been asking me for this year, and the mayor asked me, and I sat down and I read The Night Before Christmas.
Wow. Mm-hmm. What an honor.
Yes, it was. It was. And then afterwards, all the children come up and they tell me what they want.
Sure.
But this year, something funny happened. I had this little girl, and I call her Chatty Cathy because she talks and talks, and which is great. I love it. Seems like we talked for an hour, but anyhow.
Yeah, so yeah, maybe a little less.
As she is talking, her cousin comes up and starts going like this. And she looks over. She says, you have skin. Are you human? I've been talking to her for a half an hour, so she's asking me if I've been human.
Wow.
But
what comes out of the mouths of kids?
Oh, it's unbelievable. Unbelievable what comes out.
No, it truly is. You're on a roll. Carry on.
Okay. One of the things I do whenever the kids sit down, afterwards, before they leave, I ask them, what is your favorite cookie? And will you and Mommy bake a whole bunch for Santa and only five out for me and the rest share them with everybody?
Sure.
Well, this little boy, this is a breakfast with Santa. He's sitting on my lap. I said, what's your favorite cookie? And most of the kids tell me chocolate chip.
Sure.
And I said, can you do Santa a favor? And he shakes his little head. I said, on Christmas Eve, can you bake, you and Mommy bake a whole bunch of cookies and leave me five? He says, Santa, my mommy doesn't bake. She buys them all from the grocery store.
That is so cute. The honesty.
Oh, the kids, just so honest. Again, I'm doing another light up night.
Oh, yeah. Where are you headed today?
I'm going to do a light up night down on Beverly Road.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good.
Right in Mount Lebanon.
Right in Mount Lebanon. I'm doing another magical lighting of the Christmas tree. And it's so exciting. I come down on this fire truck. The lights are flashing. The siren's blowing. I get there, and the kids. Whoo, they're all over the place. I get out of the fire truck, and all they want to do is come up and touch me or whatever else. And
see if you're human.
See if I'm human, exactly.
No, that's hilarious.
And we do the magical lighting of the tree.
I'm not asking about the magic, but I guess it's special.
It is. It really is. I'll tell you, it's one of the greatest joys with the children.
How'd you come up with it?
What, Santa?
The magical
tree.
Tree.
Just created.
No, just an idea.
Just an idea, yeah. And matter of fact, that's where I started, at Bethel Park. It's totally magical. And then, you know, a lot of places that I go, they have the trees, so we like the trees.
Sure,
so,
makes sense. Goes hand in hand.
Exactly. Another question I ask the kids.
Yeah, go ahead.
Is, what does your mommy or daddy want for Christmas?
Sure, good question.
I get them at a light at night, and this little boy says, Santa, can you bring my daddy beer? I look over at daddy, says, hey, good idea. Give bring me some beer. Another little girl, who came up, and it was a very, very snowy night.
Yeah.
And she says, Santa, can you bring my mommy and daddy two things? Can you bring them chains for their car? Because we had a heck of a time getting up here. Plus, can you bring them a new car? Because ours has 300,000 miles on it and keeps breaking down.
Wow, you know, what a story. You know? Mm-hmm. Heart-wrenching for Santa.
Oh, I get some really interesting requests.
Lay a couple on us.
Okay.
Your fans are waiting, and so am I.
Get a lot of requests for little dogs, okay?
Yeah.
And what I always do is I look at the parents, and either I get a or.
Yeah.
And the ones that go no, I tell them, whatever little animal they want, I said, you know what? Santa would like to bring you that, but the sleigh that I have has no heater in it. And
right.
I don't want that little dog or cat to freeze.
Sure.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do is get in touch with your mommy and daddy in April whenever it's warm.
Yeah.
And if you still want that little cat or dog, what I will do is drop it off at the little shelter.
Yeah.
And then mommy and daddy can come and pick it up.
Great idea. Yeah. I like how quick-witted you are, Santa. That keeps peace in the families.
That's one of the things that I find is with children, you've got to think quick.
Yeah.
Case in point, I had something asked of me about 2 years ago, this beautiful little girl sitting on Santa's lap.
Yeah.
She tells me what she wants. She tells me all the cookies she likes. And then as she is getting off my lap, she turns to me and says, Santa, what do you want for Christmas?
Wow.
First time ever that I've been asked that. Wow. I thought for a second and I said, honey, I know exactly what I want for Christmas. And that is, your mommy and daddy love you very, very much. And every morning, whenever you get up, I want you to go to mommy and daddy, give them a big hug and kiss and tell them you love them. And I said, right now, I want you to go over and give mommy and daddy a big hug.
Wow.
And that's what she did. That's what she did.
What a special request.
Oh. And, you know, the children, I mean, in the years that I have been Santa, I've run into some miracles.
Okay. Get out. Lay one on us.
Okay, let me tell you this one here. I had a call. My wife took, Mrs. Claus took a call. It was for a Saturday. And this lady wanted Santa to come to her house for a party.
Yeah.
I said to Mrs. Claus, and she wanted us there at 6 o'clock. I said, Mrs. Claus, we've got a commitment at 5 o'clock, and we've got another commitment at 8 o'clock. We can't do it. She says, Santa, let me tell you what's going on. She says, this little boy who's 3 years old, he's dying of cancer. He's got 6 months to live. And she wants us there. I says, we moved our schedules. And I went over, and all these kids were there. A beautiful house party. But there was this little boy, Jacob. And he was the only one that was bald.
Yeah.
And I knew that was where the little one. So anyhow, I sit Jacob on my lap, and we're talking. And as we're done and he's telling me his gifts, I said, Jacob, will you promise Santa something? And he shakes his little head. I says, I'm coming back here next year. Will you be here? And he says, shakes. Well, that was Christmas Eve.
Right.
A month later, I ran into his aunt who had asked us to come.
Yeah.
And I said, how's Jacob? And she says, Santa, now it's getting worse. He's only been given 3 months to live.
Wow.
Well, I didn't run into the aunt again until May of that year. And I said, I ran into her and I said, how's Jacob? She says, Santa, it's like a miracle. His cancer is in remission.
Wow, that is a miracle.
I went back every year until this little boy was 11 years old, which is about the time the children... Uh-oh, somebody told them, and they're no longer believing, you know.
Right.
So, and that, like that little bell that was in a Polar Express.
Yeah.
Instead of just them hearing it, and not their mom and dad, all of a sudden they hear it because they no longer believe.
Right, right. Very interesting.
Yes, yes, yes.
That is a miracle.
Mm-hmm. Let me tell you a couple cute stories about adults.
Go ahead.
What I ask adults is, and they're sitting on my lap, think back when you were between 3 and 11 and you believed. What was your most memorable Christmas or your most memorable gift? I asked this one lady who had, she had 4 brothers and 4 sisters, so it was a big family.
Wow.
And she immediately says, 1980. And I says, what happened in 1980? She says, well, Santa, what we did is every Christmas morning we would get up and all 9 of us open our gifts and play with our gifts all morning, then come lunchtime, have a beautiful dinner, and then play with our gifts and then go to Grandma and Grandpa's.
Sure.
Well, this particular 1980, we got up, all my brothers and sisters, and Mom and Dad said, after you open your gifts, we're going to Grandma and Grandpa's. And she's thinking, why are we going to Grandma and Grandpa's? They all piled into their station wagon.
Sure.
Okay, can you see that? 9 kids plus Mom and Dad in this station wagon. They get to Grandma's, and she says, in Grandma's front yard, there's a zillion bicycles. And she, what is this all about? So then she sees all of her aunts and uncles, because her cousins were there.
Yeah.
And they got on the bikes and are riding. And she's thinking, I didn't know they could ride. And then Mom and Dad. But then the ultimate, she says, Grandma and Grandpa. And she's like, wow, I can't believe it. They're so old. Well, they came back, and Grandma says, kids, I want to let you know that last night Santa came in his gigantic sled, and he brought all these bikes for all of you. So if you just go around, you'll see your name on a bike, and you can just ride.
That is so beautiful.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, definitely.
Here's another one touching. 84-year-old gentleman sitting on my lap. I says, Bob, what is your favorite memory of Christmas?
Sure.
He said, 1938, Santa.
Wow,
1938. Why? He said, 1938 was during the Depression. My dad was unemployed. We had no money. And there was a group called the Goodfellas that came around and brought gifts. I was 6 years old, and he remembers this. My brother was 4. My other brother was 8. And at 7 o'clock, there's a knock on the door, and it's the Goodfellas.
Wow.
And they brought me and my brothers a pair of Long John underwear, a candy bar, and a cap pistol.
Wow. What a great memory.
So they left. At 8 o'clock, here's another knock on the door. Mom and Dad are saying, wow, who is this? As they open the door, it was Santa, me, with a big sack of toys. Mom and Dad are shaking their head like, who is this?
Yeah.
And, oh, Santa had all these toys, which he gave to my brother and I, and my brothers and I. And he was describing a lot of them.
Sure.
So Santa left, and his mom and dad are saying, who was that? Who was that? Sunday, Christmas Day. It was the day after Christmas that they found that the next door neighbor, who had a job and no children, what he did, he bought all the toys and he brought it over there.
Wow. Okay? What a great person.
The story doesn't stop there. 64 years ago, Bob met Pat, his wife. And he told her what happened in 1938.
Yeah.
He says, I want to do that every year. So for the last 64 years, he and Pat have been buying toys.
For others.
For others. And dropping them.
That
off.
Is so great.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah,
that beautiful?
Great stories.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Are you out of them, or do you got more?
Oh, I got more. I got more.
Well, you know I can ask.
Yeah.
Let's move forward.
Let's see. Oh. Little blind boy comes down whenever I was at Kaufman's. And we're talking, and he's telling me everything he wants. And after he's done, I say to him, do you have any other questions? And he says, yes, Santa, what is that? And I says, what's that? He says, are you the real Santa?
The
blind boy says, are you the real Santa? And I says, what do you think, Tommy? He He says, he shakes his little head. Yes.
No, that is great. Now, I'm going to interrupt you.
Go ahead.
What do you think of the Bethel Park children and people here that come to light up night?
Oh, I do two things here in Bethel, but I have been, I'm trying to think, I think it's been about 20 years now.
Wow.
That I have been coming to Bethel, and it's...
that is strong in the neighborhood.
This last year we didn't do it because of COVID.
Right, understood.
But in the past, what's happened is the mayor introduces Santa and I come up. This year was really exciting because I went to the fire department, and the fire department let me come down with the sirens going to lights. I asked the chief if I could drive the truck since I knew how to drive a sled.
Yeah, yeah.
He wouldn't let me do it.
Wow.
I don't know why, but he wouldn't let me do it.
You're a rule breaker.
Yeah.
He didn't let you break the rules.
But we come down. We're early.
Wow.
And they tell us, the mayor's still talking. We can't get out. All the kids are coming up saying, Santa, Santa, Santa. So, oh, so exciting. We go in, and as I said, it was just fantastic. But it's been absolutely wonderful.
Sure.
I do that for the community. There's a group called the Bethel Park Dancers and Gymnasts, I think it's called.
Oh, okay.
And we also do the same for some place, you know. But it's,
sure.
It's great with them, too.
No, so you have lots of fun, Santa.
I got to tell you a funny story.
Okay? Go ahead.
5 years ago. And this is the first time this ever happened. You know, the mayor and all the kids from Bethel are on the big room on the right side.
Yeah.
Well, on the left side is this party. Okay. So I go in, having a ball, and I come out. Here's this Santa who's dressed in a Walmart Santa suit. Can you picture that? I mean.
No, I cannot.
And he wants to take pictures with me.
Wow. That's crazy.
It is. It really is.
Did you take pictures?
We did. We
well,
did.
You got it. You're adoring public.
Yes. Yes. No,
so you got to do that.
Yes.
So you've had fun in each year at Bethel and doing your events here.
It's been great. It's been really great.
I've heard nothing but good feedback on this.
Mm-hmm.
You've done well.
For any of you that get the Almanac, beautiful article about Santa and the mayor and Bethel Park's light up night.
I'll have to check it out. They aren't delivering it to my house lately, so
I'll
try to get it. Yeah.
Well, you have two ways. One is to call them and ask them where. And a lot of times they drop them off at the library.
Well, our municipal building here.
Municipal building probably has them.
There's usually some out there.
Yeah, so that might be an. If they don't, ask them to bring some more.
After our show, I'll grab it if it's there.
There you go.
I'll borrow it. Bring it back. Honest, Santa. I don't want to get in trouble with you.
No, you're on my good list.
Oh, good. I'm glad I could impress you.
Yeah.
No doubt about it. No, we're about 18 minutes into this. And we've been covering, like, my special edition here, and we've done pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
And how long have you been doing this, and what happened for you to become Santa?
Okay. 21 years ago, I was retiring from a big corporation.
Okay.
And one of my friends said to me, Santa, you love to play. You love children.
Yeah.
Why don't you play Santa at Kaufman's?
So a friend told you this.
A friend at, can I mention the name of the company?
Yes.
Verizon.
That's okay.
So he said, and I said, oh, that sounds great. He says, well, how about if I get you an interview? Super. Well, I get the interview.
This is a great friend.
Great friend. As a matter of fact, he's still.
He opened the door and put you in.
Yes.
I like this friend.
So I get hired. Okay. And my first day. Well, it looks simple to put this outfit on.
It does.
But the first day, it took me 30 to 40 minutes.
Really? What happened?
Well, you know, at that time, Santa was not using his real beard.
Whoa.
But now, since Santa is a member of the real bearded and real belly.
That's
Santas.
A heck of a beard, Sam.
Oh, thank you.
I appreciate
Kids
it.
Kids can pull it. You want to pull it?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh. It's real, folks. Thank you, Santa.
You're welcome. Well, anyhow, so I'm getting dressed.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, the manager comes out, and she says, Newsweek magazine is here. They're going to watch you, and they want to interview you afterwards. And I'm thinking, Wow.
Your first day.
My first day, not only is my heart beating like this because I can't get into my outfit, now Newsweek is going to
Are you sweating?
Am I ever? I'm a nervous wreck.
I had to add that because anxiety will cause that, and you're very anxious right now.
So I go out, and I have a ball. It's great. 3 or 4 hours out there greeting all the kids. I'm done, and I come back, and Newsweek starts interviewing me. And the first question they asked me was, how long have you been doing Santa?
What a question.
And I said, believe it or not, this is my first day. They said, you are a natural. We couldn't believe how well you interacted with the
kids,
children.
Yeah.
And that started my career as Santa.
Wow. And what a day.
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't have been any better.
Not at all. It was great.
And so since then, what was your next step?
Well, after Kaufman's, I was at Macy's.
Okay. Yeah, they took over.
That was a great time.
Sure.
I was in the parade. Oh, I love it. One of my dreams has been to be in the Macy's parade in New York. It hasn't happened yet.
I've tried.
But that parade, it's wonderful.
Sure.
Then whenever Macy's closed, I thought, what am I going to do?
Right.
So I started on my own. And for those of you that want to know something about Santa, just go on my website, which is PittsburghsJolliestSanta.com.
It's a great website. Tell them again.
Pittsburgh's, PittsburghsJolliestSanta.com, JolliestSanta.com. Go in and check it out. You'll love it. I've got pictures in there. I've got my story in there.
You got a video on there.
I got a video on there. It's
Santa has technology.
I do. Santa, did I tell you about the light-up night in Pittsburgh by any chance?
No.
Okay. Oh, this is probably 8 years ago. Had a call from KDKA.
Sure.
And they said, would you and Mrs. Claus like to come down? Oh, maybe I did tell you this. No, I didn't.
No, you didn't.
Oh, okay.
You didn't.
Would like you two to come down for light up night. Hey, sounds great. Well, Santa and Mrs. Claus felt like movie stars because as we came out of the hotel, we had a police escort.
Wow.
And then we went down to the Santa hut.
That's incredible.
And the children, not only did they love Santa, but they were just, wow, there's Mrs. Claus.
You don't normally see her.
No, you don't. And one little girl, I mean, it was just an unbelievable reaction. One little girl is holding Mrs. Claus's leg and saying, Mommy, I want to go back to the North Pole with them. Well.
That is great.
Afterwards, the KDKA people told us, okay, we want you to go up on stage. Now, here's talk about some pressure.
Sure.
And lead the 200,000 or 300,000 people that are here in singing Jingle Bells, Santa's Coming to Town, and Rudolph. And they said, but after that, you know, tell them fireworks are going to be out on at the point.
Sure.
And there'll probably be no children, and you can probably go back to the North Pole. Okay. Well, I announced that fireworks are going on, but afterwards, Mrs. Claus and I are still going to be at the Santa. The line was constant. At 10 o'clock, they said, we've got to cut it off because the park is closing.
You're kidding. It was that many people there.
That was that many children.
They hung out for Santa.
They hung out for Santa. And, you know, children, they're so beautiful. One little boy who came to see us, he came back about a half an hour later with ho-hos because he figured that Santa and Mrs. Claus were hungry from the big trip down from the North Pole.
Wow, what a gift. So yeah. Santa got a gift. How were those ho-hos?
Oh, Santa likes ho-hos. Santa likes cookies. Oh.
What are your favorite cookies?
Well, what I ask the children.
Sure.
Whatever theirs is, that's my favorite.
Beyond chocolate chip.
Yeah.
Just tell me that.
Right now, one of my favorite.
I'm waiting.
Cookies. I mean, chocolate chips are good. Sugar cookies are good. But I like potato chip cookies.
Wow.
So you're going to say, what are potato chip cookies?
What are they?
I didn't know what they were. This little boy, I asked him what his favorite, and he says, potato chip cookies. I thought he was pulling Santa's leg.
Yeah.
I said to his mom, do you make potato chip cookies? She says, yes, I do. Well, I took it back to Mrs. Claus, and Mrs. Claus, being the smart lady that she is,
sure.
She actually modified it. Well, whenever she makes them, I eat so many, Elves are upset because I don't leave any for them. But they are great. Potato chip cookies.
Never heard of that.
They don't look like potato chips. They look like a chocolate chip.
Wow.
But they are, to me, a lot better. Oh, they are delicious.
Your favorite.
Wow. Oh, yes, yes. Well, you talk about, there's so many, but one right now that really sticks in my mind is I had a call again from KDKA. This one was a Kaufman's.
I'm noticing a pattern here.
I think from now on it's going to be Bethel Park. I'm going to get a lot of calls.
My BPTV fans, they're calling you.
There you go.
Definitely.
But anyhow, we get this call that this little boy is coming in, and all he wants for Christmas is his daddy home.
Wow.
Okay, and his daddy was a soldier. So he comes in to see me at Kaufman's, and he doesn't notice all the cameras like we have here.
Right.
And he sits down on my lap, and I ask him, what does he want for Christmas? And he says, Santa, all I want is my daddy.
Wow, heartbreaking.
And I said, where is daddy? He says, daddy is a soldier, and he's in Iraq.
Yeah.
And I said, you know, this morning, as I was talking to Mrs. Claus, she told me that you were coming in. So I sent my sleigh to Iraq, and I brought your daddy here. And he's here right now. And daddy comes out in his uniform. The little boys, they're screaming and they're hugging. I don't think there was a dry eye, including Santa's,
right
in that whole area.
What a story. I love it.
Isn't it? Oh,
that's one of your top ones right here.
That's one of my top ones.
On our Talking Machine special edition show, you topped it.
Yeah.
You topped out. Well, we got about a minute and a half to go. Can you do another story?
Oh, I can. I was just thinking of this one.
Go ahead.
Well, let me tell you. You know, one of the things, Santa has a great time and with the children, but every so often, things happen that, you know, really makes you think about
throws
it.
Throws you for a loop.
And, again, this little girl comes with her daddy, and she has a gift. And Santa thought it was for him. And, I said, you brought Santa a gift. And she says, no, Santa.
Oh.
Mommy died 2 months ago.
Wow.
Could you take her this gift up in heaven? And I said, I definitely will. As a matter of fact, before I got here, I talked to your mommy, and she's up in heaven, and she wanted me to tell you that she misses you very, very much and that she loves you. And she thinks of you every day.
That is great.
Isn't it?
Yeah, that is so great. Now, hey, we're going to have to close it out.
Let me tell you one more. Can we have another minute?
We got close to it.
Okay, real quick. Santa does Christmas Eve at one of the local churches.
Okay.
And at the end of church services, the minister says, do you hear that? And I start ringing my bells.
Sure, try it.
Okay. I start ringing my bells. And as I'm going up, I have a gift. And I want to show the kids what the true meaning of Christmas is. It's not about Santa, but it's about the birth of Jesus Christ.
Sure.
And I go up, and I go up to the manger. I put the gift down. I take off my hat. I say a prayer. I get back up. I put my hat back on, and I wish everybody a very blessed and merry Christmas. You would not believe how many people come to me afterwards with tears in their eyes saying, that's the true meaning of Christmas.
You ended this show perfectly, Santa. Thank you so much. And how do they get a hold of you again?
Okay. The best thing is to go on my website, and my phone number's there. Again, it's pittsburghsjolliestsanta.com. And if you forget that, just call my good friend Al here, and he has one of my business cards. I'm going to give you some more. You can send them on. Or just,
I'll take them.
There you go. We'll give you a whole bunch.
Just for everybody in Bethel Park. We'll keep it simple.
Santa's here to make all the good little boys and girls very, very happy at Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas, everybody. Ho, ho, ho.